she asks me where I was from, I said somewhere you never been to. Little town outside of Knoxville, hidden by some dogwood trees. She tried talking with my accent. We held hands and waded into that blue water. She left her flip-flops by my red wings on the beach. Yeah, but now I'm dodging potholes in my sunburned Silverado, like a heartbroken desperado, headed right back to my roots. Something about the way she kissed me tells me she loved Eastern Tennessee. Yeah, but all I brought back with me was some sand in my boots. I said, let's go shoot tequila. So we walked back to that beach bar.
Computer off. Computer off. What the fuck is going on? I think I figured it all out. And I mean, you know, I wouldn't think anyone would go to such extremes. When there's blood in the street, guys. When there's fucking blood in the street, start buying. Start buying. But you know, at first I started thinking about this fucking idiot. You know, I've made videos for a long time about this guy that bashed our fucking community for years. And then all of a sudden, you know, things change. We'll get into that. Fucking Bitboy. And this is just another fucking situation, narrative, for the exact same thing. Watch this shit. What the fuck? This fucking guy. Bitch boy. Here we go.
Lamborghini right here in his garage. Oh. So today, guys, I'm going to be live streaming and I'm going to be telling the entire story of Carlos Diaz.
This motherfucker would have about 50 holes in him at this point. I mean, I don't need some fucking idiot asshole, fat ass, short motherfucker in my driveway. Oh, I'm not afraid of you. This motherfucker, he'd have a dick in his mouth right now. Right now. Right there. Fucking, let's listen. We'll get into this. Fucking bitch.
Carlos Diaz, this. I'm going to be talking about all the people he's affiliated with. I'm going to be talking about how he got into my building. I'm going to talk about all of it. Hope you guys are ready. This is he just answered the door. So I know this is him for sure. Right here. I'm not scared of you, Carlos. I'm not scared.
I'm not scared of you, Carlos. Guys,
let me tell you. Are you ready? I'm gone out of town. I'm out of town. What happens? What happens when I'm out of town? Carlos comes and knocks on our door at Hit Network. Okay? The same man just came to his house. And Carlos says this. Hey, man. He says this to Justin and TJ because Justin and TJ were there. And I was out of town. So here's what happens. Okay? What occurs? Hold on one second. Hold on one second. Let me put this up here. Hold on one second. One second. One second. Hold on. I need to put something up. I don't think he's going to kill me.
I'm not afraid of you. I don't think he's going to kill me. But you know what I notice? You know, later, I'm pretty sure it's later in this video. I haven't watched the whole thing, but I was watching the one where he got arrested. You know, everybody's like, oh, he's on fucking drugs and everything. I thought he was too. But, you know, now I'm starting to see something different. He's not fucking on drugs. You know, he's going to wind up getting arrested by a cop with some bitch in the car, some fucking money grab whore, hoe, and that he cheated on his wife with. And the whole fucking Twitter space of saying, hey, shouldn't have cheated on her, asshole. And, you know, I'm starting to wonder if that was even fucking, it wasn't even, like, arranged. You know, you say, oh, someone wouldn't go through all this shit. But you know what? Every great wealth is from a great crime. And right at this point, he's just fucking with the justice system. It all ends with fucking Bitboy having a bunch of subs and these motherfuckers making up, making out, and doing everything. This is so staged. If Bitboy was really afraid for his life, he wouldn't be there. And he wouldn't be saying, I don't think he's going to kill me. He is preying upon the weak-minded. And, you know, he's using the police and everything. And, you know, you say, why would he do that? Well, this motherfucker's making thousands of dollars a day. It's worth it. Watch. You'll see the fake shit if you look close enough. Just look into his fucking crooked eyes. He looks like one of those stupid fucking dogs.
I don't think he's gonna kill me live on YouTube.
Huh? YouTube's everything.
So, the point is,
you're gonna YouTube yourself when your
knocks on my door.
Fleeing is in the car.
He says, man, I love Bitboy Crypto. Love Bitboy Crypto. Remember, I'm not there. I'm not there. Justin and
that's
TJ
the Supreme
are there.
Commander
Notice
of
he
XRP. After
you
he fucking ripped us apart.
Why?
For years, motherfucker.
Because of everything he has done.
Motherfucker.
What Carlos has done. So.
What have you done?
Right here, bud. So the point is, he comes and he knocks on my door at work and says, I love Bitboy Crypto. I don't know if that's what he said or not. That's what Justin and TJ told me that he said. Justin and TJ told me that Carlos came to the door.
Why does that even matter if you're trying to get your Lambo, bitch?
And said, hey, I love Bitboy Crypto. I want to be part of this. So what happens? He goes to Justin Williams and he says, hey, did you know I'm in real tight with Mike Will Made It?
Why do you think we fucking
care?
Mike
Will Made It is a big producer, okay?
He got on the XRP bandwagon because his channel, you know, they were running out of shit. They needed more viewers, and there's a huge community with us. And they figured if we can just capture 20% of that community, we fucking win. Well, he captured like 80%. And those motherfuckers that believe in him, they have a short fucking memory. And, you know, they got the shit backwards. I mean, what the fuck? Why would you kick my mother in the face for years and then you're going to say you love her so it's okay? You abusive fucking prick. I'd love to just meet him for 2 minutes and have him say the wrong fucking thing. Or actually do the wrong fucking thing.
He worked with Black Beatles Ray Shrimmer. Okay. Ear Drummers. Some people call them Mannequin Challenge. We also have, Miley Cyrus with.
Okay, so if this is real, why is he like throwing all these commercials and information out, right? Let's just skip ahead, see where this goes.
A lot of talking, and that's for you guys. He's got loose lips, extremely loose lips. He will say anything.
Loose lips,
let's talk about
sink ships, the way you move, you don't miss.
Congresswoman.
I said I told you, I'll get to know you. We're going all the way. Move over, I'm gonna hold you to everything you say. Now I've told you, baby, everything today. And when I hold you, I'll get to know you. We're gonna be okay. All the way, you say you'll take me. Any day, you never break me. Slip, slip, slip in the lips. I like the way you move your hips. A loose lips, a sink ships. The way you move, you don't miss. I mean, come on, motherfucker.
Woman from California. Now, I want to be very clear here. What Carlos told me is false, I believe. I don't think they're... Well, when you listen to how idiotic it sounds, this will make sense to you.
They're okay? Fucking best friends.
Guys, please.
They're going to work this out, and everything's going to be fine. They're going to have 10 times more followers.
These people have tried
people
to destroy
believe
my life,
this shit.
And I'm standing up for it, and I'm saying, no more, Carlos! No more! I'm not accepting it.
No one in this situation would be more infatuated with the camera than what's behind them. If he's worrying about his life, why is he turning his back every 5 fucking seconds? Let's go ahead. I can't stomach this shit.
What's going on? Hey. He also said, let's talk about Maxine Waters. You guys know Maxine Waters? The congresswoman from California? Now, I want to be very clear here.
To you, I'm just a man. To me, you're all I am.
When you listen to how idiotic it sounds, this will make sense to you, okay? And guys, please, there is no cool, calm, and collected for me. I'm emotional. These kind of
seems like
he
went out. Kind of seems like he just went out there to film a video. Still haven't seen him go up to the house or do anything.
I'm standing up for it, and I'm saying no more.
What's going on?
This we can definitely see the girl I had an affair. Put the phone down. Okay. All right.
Put the phone down. Put the fanny pack down.
Okay.
Put the fucking bitch ass pack down, motherfucker.
This man inside of this house.
Actually, he's gonna check you real quick.
Yeah, absolutely.
Get the weapon.
I'm sorry. I have a. All right. Okay. Yep.
Knew the cops were gonna come, and he had a gun in his car.
It's in the back seat.
I mean, you can't be outside for fucking 20 minutes and screaming and have a gun in the car and not expect the cops to come at dusk.
No weapons.
Where in the car is your gun?
It's in the back seat.
Back seat?
Yep.
Is anybody else in the car?
Yes, there's somebody in the car.
Who's in the car? Who?
What's that?
Who's in your car?
Who's in my car?
Yes.
Okay. Let's,
Who's in your car?
Notice how he looked at the camera to act like, ooh, I shouldn't say this. You guys pay attention. Fucking Bitboy.
Where's my car?
Who's in your truck, sir?
Cassie is in my car. Cassie's in my truck.
All right, Cassie.
And if you don't know who Cassie is, if you're a new viewer, he's going to explain it to you. Because that's a normal reaction to tell a cop that you had an affair with someone.
It's in my truck. My wife knows that we're here, by the way. She knows we came to do this. But my wife is aware. So we're live on YouTube right now.
Okay.
We've got about 2,500 people watching. So Cassie is a girl I had an affair with. She's involved in the situation with me and this guy here. My wife knows.
That has nothing to do with the situation with the cops.
Cassie and I have came over here because this man is extraordinary.
I mean, are you believing it yet? This motherfucker.
He stole my Lamborghini. My Lamborghini is in his...
I mean, you guys... I mean, it all comes down to he's making his money from YouTube, not crypto. If he was making money hand over fist from crypto like he claims, he wouldn't need YouTube. It would be dwarfed. It would be like, hey, why don't you drive 3 hours to work in icy, icy snow fucking conditions to make minimum wage for 30 minutes and then turn around to do it again? But guess what? You got to come back two more fucking times tonight. That's what YouTube money would be like to him if you listen to how much fucking money he makes. It's all the fucking game. I've joked and said he doesn't own any crypto. What I'm really saying is this. He makes his money from YouTube. Be cautious. Be aware. And understand. When you're listening to all these motherfucking bad narratives... Know this, that is the time to buy. It's hard. I understand. I feel the pain. I know people have shit. They're worried about having to fucking sell some of their crypto because this shit's taking 10 times longer and they probably don't even know how they made it this fucking long if you've been in it as long as me. And we're fighting. We know there could be a surprise tomorrow that could fucking really hurt our stack or just... bills and shit coming in because we projected some income that we thought we'd have at this point in time. And I'm one of them. And we should be right. And it's not there. So you're hodling, holding on for your dear life to a fucking time frame. To a point in time. And then you're wrong. You know, you think, God, it's going to happen for sure at this date. And then it doesn't. And now you're fucking 3 months later, 6 months later. It's going to happen soon. A year later, 2 years later. And then you finally get the fucking gift. The price goes up and then it drops right fucking back down to where it was. Are you pissed? Yeah. Don't be mad at Bitboy for that. Be mad at Ripple. Be mad at Jeb. They're fucking brothers, I'm telling you. They're working with the banks. They're working with the man. Brad Gerlinghaus said that. Yeah, he has a nice smile, but make no mistake. He was telling you everything that day. You'll get paid, but we're going to fuck you along the way. We're going to manipulate the price. Brad Gerlinghaus admitted to manipulating the price by saying we're kind of like a market maker with the escrow. Jeb, he was selling 1-2% supply. Don't hold me accountable for that, but that's about what it was depending on the time frame. And people say, oh, that didn't really hurt the price. You don't think the cascading effect of one of the biggest creators of XRP selling at a low price wouldn't hurt the price? What percentage is that worth? 10, 20, 30, 40? To a sophisticated person, probably 40 or more. And then you don't think selling just 1% a day would make a difference? Well, over the course of 10 days, that would be 10%. 20 days, 20%. And then you also have the cascading effect of people selling because he's selling. And then you got Ripple selling. I'm sorry, playing like a market maker, as they would say. I mean, are you fucking kidding me? How does the price go right back to where it was after we get such a huge settlement unless it was manipulated? This is not something we haven't suspected or heard about in the past. But what it is confirmation that we're fucking right. And I'm fucking sick of it. Brad, you're no fucking hero, dude. You're no fucking hero. You know what, but if XRP, if you manipulate the price to $10 tomorrow, I'll suck your dick, Brad. You know, I might even pat you in the ass, you fucking bitch. You know, sex in prison, it's not like gay. And I don't care if someone's fucking gay, I'm just not gay. It's an act of fucking power, Brad. Brad, pick up the fucking soap, bitch. You guys, this is so much bullshit. It's all a show. All the world is indeed a stage. We're merely players, betrayers. Each another's audience outside the gilded stage. What do you got to know? I mean, the more bad I hear, the more I try to fucking go in between the couch cushions and pull some change out so I can buy something. And I haven't been able to buy in a couple weeks, and it's fucking killing me. Because I got, like, two daughters that are little that want all dad's money. My wife, she's a good woman. My son, he doesn't ask for much. So when he wants it, it's usually big shit, and I can't say no. But really, it's just, I keep buying shit, like buildings and shit. And it's like, I was expecting to have more cash. So I'm like, fuck, I hope I don't have to cut into my fucking crypto on fucking Coinbase, you know? But, you know, whatever. You guys, don't listen to Bitboy. He's been lying to us the whole time. And you really think for the amount of money he's making for these video views, it's not worth going to getting arrested? Or, you know, creating all this illegal stuff. At the end, when they find out it's all bullshit, there's going to be nothing for them to prosecute. They walk. Mark my words.